Hi, welcome to today's security vlog. Today we are discussing about USB security. Well, the USB devices are becoming the new battleground of hacker attacks because the USB manufacturers are making their USB devices with a goal that the USB devices should be able to do many different functions other than just storing and transferring the data, and this is what made easy for hackers to attack. When the USB devices are connected, the computer run a type of software known as firmware, and this firmware makes the USB to function, and the vulnerability is all in the firmware, and there is no real way to check and verify the USB devices firmware whether it is safe or not. The malicious firmware could function as an USB keyboard when the USB is connected to the computer. It opens a command prompt window, download a program from a remote server, run it and agree to USC prompt automatically in just matter of seconds without the user input. And it was more sneaky, the USB driver and computer could appear to function normally to the user, but the firmware could modify files as they leave the device, infecting them. A special type of USB device which you are seeing right now on the screen was designed by the hackers, which also functions as a Ethernet adapter and route traffic malicious servers. A phone or any type of USB device with its own internet connection could use that connections to relay information from your computer. The computer which are infected could infect the newly connected USB drives by replacing the firmware of the USB drive with the malicious firmware, so that the every system was infected to which your USB connected. This type of attacks are called as bad USB attacks, and those systems will infect the new USB when they are connected, and this process goes on from computer to USB and USB to computer. There was also another type of attack called as juicejacking. This has happened in the past with USB drives containing malware that depend on the Windows autoplay feature to automatically run malware on computers they were connected to. But now the antivirus utilities can't detect or block this new type of infection that could spread from device to device. This could potentially be combined with juicejacking attacks to infect a device as it charges via USB from malicious USB port. There is a good news and the bad news. The good news is that it is only possible with about 50% of USB devices of late 2014, and the bad news is that you can't tell which devices are vulnerable and which are not. So manufacturers will hopefully design USB devices more securely to protect their firmware from being modified in the future. So now, how to be safe with this? Well, you need to turn on auto USB scan when connected in your antivirus program and turn off the autoplay feature in your operating system. Well, this action may stop some but not all. Use some softwares like USB Disk Security, Panda, USB Vaccine, etc., which are designed for these attacks to stop some more. Well, I have some other way type of solution which I found on the internet. Just follow the steps which you are seeing right now on the screen. You can even take a screenshot of that. First, you have to open a notepad, then type what was mentioned to type in the second step. Save the file with any type of name by placing .reg extension. Then right click on it, choose merge and confirm any warning prompt to add the information to the registry. Do all the things which are said in this video. Stay safe, stay secure. Subscribe to my channel if you are new. Like this video and share it with your friends. See you in the next video. Bye.